Hi, folks, it's good to be with you today. We're here to share the Word of God today. And we're sharing the Word of God. And we're looking at Psalm 27. And in Psalm 27, it says in Psalm 27, says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fall. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou said, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, I seek thy face, the face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face from me," he says. "I had fainted unless I had lived to see the goodness of the Lord. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall be strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord." It says that the Lord is my light. It says the Lord is my rock. It says the Lord is my strength. And in the midst of life, in the midst of problems, in the midst of difficulties, in the midst of challenges, we need to find a place. We need to find a place where we can settle in our hearts, a place where we can settle, where we know that we're on a rock, where we know we're on a foundation, where we know that we can stand in the midst of trial. Because one thing that you need to know is that you will have trial in your life. You'll have trial. Trials will come your way. Trials will come your way. So how do you cope with trials? It says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Light shines in the darkness. When you don't know the way, he shines in the way. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. And if you trust in Jesus, he is the light that shines in the darkness. He is the one that shines in the problems. He is the one that shines in your life and gives you direction. He says, I am the light of the world. It says in Psalm 27 verse 1. God bless you. It says in Psalm 27 verse 1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? You don't have to fear the wrath of God. You don't have to fear judgment day if you know Jesus. To Jesus, if you trust in Jesus, he took away your punishment. He took your punishment upon himself. He took the wrath that you deserve. When he died in your place. The wrath of God fell upon him, and he died on a ransom for you. He died in your place. The wrath of God fell upon him for all your sin and my sin. Whatever you did wrong, whatever I did wrong, he died in your place. He died in my place. He was your substitute. It says in the Word of God, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? But without God in your life, then what is going to happen to you when you die? What is going to happen to you when you die? Every one of us is going to die. Every one of us is going to die, folks. Whether you like it or not, every one of us is going to die. Every single one of us is going to die. We're all going to die. But the psalm says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? I don't even have to fear. I don't have to fear death. If I believe in Christ, if I trust in Christ, if I believe in Christ, if I know Christ as my Lord and Christ as my Savior, I don't have to fear death. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? I don't have to fear death. I don't have to fear anything because God will be with me, and the same with you. But you have to exercise faith in the gospel. The gospel is the good news. The gospel is Jesus Christ died on the cross. That is the gospel, that he gave his life for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. That is the good news, that he came to die on that cross to set you free from judgment, so that there could be in your life, there is now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. And he died on that cross to set you free. To set you free from the wrath of God. To set you free from the judgment to come. When every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So my friend, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Drugs. Drugs will destroy your life. Drugs will take your life down. Drugs will destroy your life. Materialism will destroy your life. You have a soul, and that soul needs to be full of God. But we fill it with materialism. We fill it with religion. We fill it with all sorts of things that are not helpful to us. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? But what you need in your life is light. What you need in your life is light that will shine in the darkness and set you free. But if we cling to the world, if we cling to the things of the world is walking in darkness. The world is walking in darkness. It says the heart is deceitful and the heart is deceitful and wicked above all things. And we walk in darkness. And Jesus is the light. It's not politics. Politics will not save us. Religion will not save us. Science will not save us. Philosophy will not save us. The only thing that will save us is the light. And Jesus is the light. It says in the Word of God, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Jesus says, I am the light of the world. And it is the truth of Christ, who Christ is, that Christ is the Son of God. He's more than a prophet. And he's not an angel. He is God in the flesh. That's who Jesus is. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus is God. He's more than a prophet. A prophet, priest, and king, but he's also God in the flesh. And Jesus is the light of the world. He is the way we're to live, and he is our Savior. And it's only by looking to Jesus, as you look to the Son, your eyes will feel light and warmth. And unless we look to the Son of God, unless we look to the Son of God, unless we look to him, there'll be no light in this world. The world is like the sun is shining. The sun is shining. And there the sun shines, and then a dark cloud comes and covers the sun. And covers the sun. And the light goes, and it's dark. We're living in a dark world because we're not looking to the Son of God. We're not looking to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We're not looking to him who is altogether lovely. We're not looking to Jesus. He is the answer to our problems today. Politicians will only mess things up. They'll only make things worse. They'll do social engineering, but they'll only make it worse. Only the Son of God can change hearts. Only the Son of God can bring love. Only the Son of God can make us anew. Only the Son of God, living in men and women's hearts by the power of his Holy Spirit, Flesh gives birth to flesh, and spirit gives birth to spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but spirit gives birth to spirit. And unless a man and a woman is born again, unless you have a new heart from God, you cannot be saved. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but spirit gives birth to spirit. And it is the spiritual man that is to be born again by the Spirit of God. That is only what will save us. A new birth from heaven, a heavenly new birth, a heavenly new life, a heavenly new life, a new birth in the heart of man, the power of the Holy Ghost in your heart. When the Spirit of God comes in and fills your heart, it cannot be filled by philosophy. It cannot be filled by science. It cannot be filled by religion. It cannot be filled by moralism. It can only be filled by God Himself, who comes in your heart and changes you. Where you meet God and are forgiven. Where you're cleansed and made anew. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but spirit gives birth to spirit. I could argue with you all day. I could give you arguments till your ears are falling off. I could give you all the arguments you want. I can give you all the evidence you want. But until your heart opens to God, you'll never find Him. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but spirit gives birth to spirit. And unless you become a spiritual man, unless you become a spiritual woman, unless your spirit is renewed, you cannot know God. And God is longing that you would hear. Longing, but we are walking in a nightmare, my friends. We are ghosts living in this world, and we're ghosts. We're shadows of our real selves, and we are ghosts. And we're like zombies walking to hell. Zombies walking to hell. That's what we are. Walking on our crack cocaine. Walking on our porn. Walking on our materialism. And zombies that go to hell. God bless you, bro. God bless you, bro. Nice to meet you. Have a look at that. Zombies walking to hell. But He loved you. He loved you that He died for you. That He died on that cross for you. Would your drug dealer die for you? Would your crack cocaine dealer die for you? Would your porn channel die for you? Would your porn channel die for you? Would your drug dealer die for you? Would the politicians die for you? Would they die for you? He died for you. God demonstrated His own love for us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus, vast unmeasured, boundless, free, rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus, vast unmeasured, boundless, free, rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, that old Him, that old Him, God bless you, son. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, and can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's love? And can it be that He would die for you and me? Assalamu alaikum. God bless you. That He would come and die for you and me. That He came from His throne in heaven, and that He came to this world in the muck of this world and was born on a stable and whipped and mocked. Can it be that He would die for you and me? He who made the stars, He who made the heavens, He who created it all came and born in a stable. Born in a stable. He humbled himself and made himself of no reputation. Philippians chapter 2. He thought it not robbery to be equal with God. But he made himself of no reputation and humbled himself even to the death of the cross. And he humbled himself. And oh, he humbled himself. Look at him there, how he humbled himself. Could Ed Sheeran ever do this? Could Theresa May do this? God bless you, bro. Could Theresa May do it? Could anybody in Parliament do it? Could anybody in the House of Lords do it? How he humbled himself. He humbled himself. And there they took him and they whipped his back. They whipped his back. They whipped his back. They mocked him. They spat at him. Could you do that? Could you do that? They spat at him. And they laughed at him and they mocked him and they humiliated him. And nobody was there to help him. Nobody was there to save him. And there he was whipped and mocked. Would Boris Johnson do that for you? Would Theresa May do that for you? Would Nicola Sturgeon do that for you? But there, he's allowing them to mock him, humiliate him for you. For there, as they took him to that cross, he was going as your savior. He was going out of love for you as your savior. And they beat him and beat him, and then they put a crown of thorns on his head. They crushed the crown on his head. They crushed it into his skull. And then they nailed his hand one, and his hand two, and his feet, and they lifted him up. Look at him! The Son of God loved you and died for you. Look at him! Hanging on that cross. Hanging on that cross for you, my friend. Hanging on that cross for you. For you. For you, my friend. And all that God wants you to do is forsake that which you know is wrong in your life. Swearing like a gangster rapper. Anything that you know is not right. We turn away. Porn addiction, drug addiction, whatever it is, we turn away and we go to the Master Jesus. We go to him, the Master. The Master knows your heart. He knows your pain. He knows your problems. He knows your struggles. The Master knows your heart better than you and me. He knows your heart. And the Master wants to come into your heart and abode with you and be your Savior. Take my life and let it be. Take my moments and my days and let them flow in ceaseless praise. Will you let him take you? Will you let him be your Savior today? Let him take control of your heart. Take control of your life. Take control of your time. Let him take control of you. You have been king of your life. You are the king of your life. And what has your life become? You're the king of your life, the queen of your life. What has your life become? When we go in our own strength and our own wisdom, we make a mess of it. But if we hand our lives to Jesus, hand our lives to God, he will make sweetness out of your life. Sweetness out of your life. If only you would hand your life to him. If only you would hand your life to him. But you hold on to the drugs, you hold on to the sex, you hold on to the material, and joy in you. Let it go. Let it go. And let Christ in. Let Christ in. Let it fill you with a new heart, with new joy, with new peace. God bless you, bro. With a new heart, new peace, and new joy. All things become new. God bless you, bro. All things become new, my friend. God bless you. All things become new, my friend, as you believe it. Your life will change. I guarantee when Jesus becomes your bestie, who's your bestie today? Who's your bestie? Who's your bestie today? When Jesus becomes your bestie, number one, God bless you. When he becomes your number one, you'll change, you'll be a new man, you'll be a new woman when you allow him number one in your life. Will you let him be number one in your life? Let him be number one. And you'll find hope, peace in your life. Let him be number one. What, do you want to debate me, son? Come and debate me, sir. God bless you, bro. So I want to talk about evolution again. Can anyone prove to me evolution's true? Can anyone show me that evolution's true, that we came from apes? Can anybody give me any evidence? Guys, anybody? Anybody got any evidence for evolution? I've had a PhD in biology walk past me and wanted to debate me on evolution, and then they scarpered to the pub because they didn't want to debate me. Does anybody want to debate me on evolution? Anybody got any evidence against for evolution? Anybody? Nah, you see, there's no evidence for evolution. We were created. You see, you think people would come and debunk creationism and bring evidence against me and show that evolution's true. You'd think that, wouldn't you? In Manchester, you'd think that they'd come and give me evidence for evolution. Well, let's ask them. Has anybody got any evidence for evolution? Have you got any evidence for evolution? Come on. No evidence for evolution, you see? No evidence for evolution. I've had a scientist who's a PhD in biology. She wanted to debate me. I asked her one question. Goes to the pub. She couldn't answer it. She couldn't answer it. See, God created this world. This world is God's. He created it. He's the creator. He created the world, and the world fell into sin and rebelled against God. And all the evil and all the mess that you see today is because man is a fallen creature. Man is in rebellion against God. That's why we have wars. That's why we have murders and hatred. Man has rebelled against God. Man has rebelled against God. And because man has rebelled against God, God gave his law, the Ten Commandments. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall use the name of the Lord, the name of the Lord in vain. You should not lie. Do not commit adultery, honor your father and mother, and keep the Sabbath day, and do not covet. God gave his Ten Commandments. Here's a question. Have you lied today? Have you lied to the tax man? Have you lied to services? Have you been lying to your girlfriend and your boyfriend? Have you been lying today? Bible says, thou shalt not lie. Have you been lying to the tax man? Have you been lying to the council? Have you been lying to your girlfriend, your boyfriend? Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not lie. Have you been lying? Have you been lying? Have you been lying to your girlfriend or boyfriend? Have you been lying to your mama and your papa? Have you been lying to the government? Thou shalt not lie, the Bible says. Thou shalt not lie, the Bible says. Have you been lying?
Thou shalt not lie.
Thou shalt not lie. Have you been lying? Thou shalt not lie.
You should be lying.
You've been lying. Thou shalt not lie. Jesus died for your lies. Jesus died for your lies. When he hung on the cross, he was being punished for your lies. He died on that cross for your lies, my friend. Gave his life for your lies. Gave his life for you on that cross. So will you come to him today? Come to him while you can. Trust him while you can. Have faith in him while you can. The offer is there for you today. Whoever you are, Christ offers himself to you. He says, come to me, all you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. He offers himself to you today. Whoever you are, if you believe in him, you will have eternal life. If you believe in him, you'll find hope and salvation. Believe in him and trust him as your Lord and Savior, you will find salvation and hope. You'll find forgiveness. You'll find peace and joy. You'll find all that you need in him. All that you need in him. Give me all in my life, keep me burning. Give me all in my lamp, I pray. Give me all in my life, keep me burning. Keep me burning till the break of day. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King. Give me all in my life, burning. Give me all in my lamp, I pray. Hallelujah, give me all in my lamp, keep me burning. Keep me burning to the break of day. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King. Jesus loves you, ladies. Give me love in my heart, keep me loving. Give me love in my heart, I pray. Hallelujah, give me love in my heart, keep me loving. Keep me loving till the break of day. Come on, this is better than Rocky Bucky. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King. Give me all in my life, keep me burning. Give me all in my life, I pray. Hallelujah, give me all in my life, keep me burning. Keep me burning till the break of day. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna, sing Hosanna to the King. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna, God bless you, bro. God bless you. Keep up doing the work, yeah? God bless you. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Okay, sorry about that. Oh, okay, sorry. Okay, bro, okay. Okay, I haven't been here for 2 weeks, mate. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Amen. It's just a bite.